When you consider Hashem as a father, as a mother, He will be next to you.
I came late this morning because I had a shiur upstairs. Over there, you know, there is two parashiyot. They are next to the other, the parashat Kitavo and the parashat Nitzavim. The parashat Kitavo, the Torah talk about when Hashem said to the people of Israel, when I give you, when you enter the land of Israel, and Hashem will give you the Eretz Israel, and you will have your own land, your own field, you will bring the first fruit to Yerushalayim. This is the parashat. And if you do that, so Eretz Israel will be yours. But if Hashem Shalom, you don't do that, so you will go to exile. So today, unfortunately, we don't have Eretz Israel. We're in America, we're in Morocco, we're in France, we're in Europe, we're everywhere. This is the parasha of Kitavo. The parasha of Nitzavim, it talks about Hashem, he did a brit, he did an alliance with the Jews. Moshe Rabbeinu, he said to the minister, Atem Nitzavim, Hayim Kula, you are all of you standing today here. From the big people to the small people. Poor people, rich people, all kinds of people. Moshe Rabbeinu told them, all of you. Don't think that Hashem, he prefers only tzaddikim. HaKadosh Baruch Hu loves even the Rasha'im. Even the Rasha'im, Hashem loves them. Why? Because even the Rasha, he's a Rasha. Tomorrow he may do teshuvah. Today is a Rasha. He has the opportunity. Maybe tomorrow he will do teshuvah. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And the proof that Hashem loves the Rasha'im, that they are alive. If he didn't love them, they die. HaKadosh Baruch Hu give a chance. The chance, as long as you live, there is a chance. Rabotai, in the parasha of Nitzavim, Moshe Rabbeinu, he said, Hashem is going to do an alliance, a brit with all of you, from the top people till the small people. Those are the two parashiyot. One parasha talk about premises, the first fruit that you bring to Israel, that you bring to Yerushalayim. The second parasha is the brit. But I was, you know, Shvei Panim Batorah, you can explain the Torah in a lot of ways. One of the ways that I am thinking to explain this parasha, it's this, but please listen to this. The parasha is that a man, a person, when he's there, up there, he don't want to come here. Once you are there, it's like a person who lives in a palace. Hey, he wants to remain in the palace. In the palace, he has everything there. He is the king, he has everything. What do you want? What do you want to go outside? Yes, all the olam is in the palace. But Hashem, he said, no. You have to come here. Because only here, in this world, you can know the reality. Because it's like, you know, a child, he will appreciate his parent only when he's outside his house. In his house, he has everything. In his house, he has everything. He's a very... whatever he wants, his mother gives him. Whatever he wants, his father gives him. But, so, he doesn't appreciate his parents. But once he's outside his house, he's lonely, with no money, nowhere to sleep, nowhere to be, he appreciates, when I was in my house, my mother, how she took care of me. So, you see, Hashem, he said to Hashem, he's talking to the neshama. You cannot appreciate me as of you here. You have to go down there. You have to go to that Olam Hazeh. There in the Olam Hazeh, you will see, you will be only on your own. And then you will see what, then you will appreciate who I am. Now, this is, to make the story short, this is the parasha, how it's going, with the neshama. At the time, the Pekah would say, "Be'al-kohach atanutzar, be'al-kohach atanulad." The neshama, she don't want to come to this world. She want to remain up there. She said, "Please, Hashem, down there, maybe I will be Rasha. It's too risky. Maybe it's Manhattan, it's New York, it's Paris, it's dead. And please, this Zankov, nah, please, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I want to stay with you here." Hashem said, "No. Here, you will not, here, you only know one way. You only know one word. I want you to know the other word so you can appreciate this word. To appreciate this word, you have to test yourself. And the other word, then you will make a comparison. You will compare between up down there and up there." And at the end, HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to the neshama, "Look, I will be with you. You will not be lonely. There is Torah." So this world, Be'emet, you can live Gan Eden in the Torah. Be'emet. You can live Gan Eden through Torah, through mitzvot, through ma'asim Torah. People, they don't know what he means. People, they don't know what he means. They think, I'm a millionaire. I have this. Vacation. Yes. But this we will not take it with you. This you will not take it with you. This, you know what I said one day? Why this olam we call it olam ha-sheker? Why this world we call it the world of lie? Why the, and up there we call it olam ha-emet, the world of the truth. Why? Why here we live in the lie? Why, I am here. Why there is America? Can you say there is no America? No, there is exists. How can you? I'm from Paris. I live in France. No. It's lie. You're lying. No. There is no Paris. There is no Paris. I have my passport. I'm French citizen. No. It's lie. What does that mean? We call this olam ha-sheker. We call this olam the olam of lie. And up there is the olam of emet. Okay, be there. Up there is the olam of emet, but here as well is the olam of emet. Why? How can you see this word? Is the word of the sheker? The reason is. What is this emet? Emet. If in this world you have to be a good Jew, Torah, mitzvot, ma'asim tovim. And you can be a millionaire. But your premises, your ikar, is the Torah. For me, being Jew before my money. Of course you will need the money. A man who tells you he doesn't like money is a liar. We all want money. Without money, we cannot do mitzvot. Without money, we cannot do ni Shabbat, no Hagim, no Ma'adim, nothing. We need money. We pray to Hashem, Parnassah. Yes, we want Parnassah. But your preference should be, you have to give always priority to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Money comes second. Not business before Hashem. Hashem before business. If you put Hashem before business, so you live in Olam HaEmet. Even that you live here, you live in Olam HaEmet. Because you realize that money, you will not take it with you. But if you give your money priority before Hashem, so you live in Olam HaSheker. Why? Because after 120 years, you will not take it with you. What you take with you? Nothing. So you arrive up there. Welcome. How are you? Baruch Hashem. Well, what did you bring with you? Well, down there I have a lot of account, and I have a lot of cars, and a lot of, where are they? Down there. But you are here. No, I'm not down there. Can you go? Take them. Bring them here. Here we don't accept them. So up there, we don't accept them. So if you don't accept them, that means what? That means that all your life, you've been working for that, and now you are down up there, and they are not with you. So it's Olam HaSheker. What it is, Emet, wherever you go, you take it with you. This is the Olam HaEmet. Here in this world, wherever you go, with your cat, you can get whatever you want. But with your cat up there, it doesn't work. If object doesn't work, say a poor man. So you've been working for nothing. So this is Olam Emet. This is Olam HaSheker. But you can live in this Olam, which we call him Olam HaSheker, when you are keeping Torah mitzvot ma'asim tovim. And Baruch Hashem, that's why HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave us Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. Rosh Hashanah and Kippur, that we can change our way of living. If all year I was giving priority to material, all year I was giving priority to my body, all year I was giving priority to everything, to vacation, now I want to give priority to Hashem, because finally I will take nothing with me. Finally. This is Rabotai. Ki tavo el haaretz. Hashem, he said, after 120 years, you will come up there. What's going to happen? If you don't have premises, priority, the Bikurim, the Torah, mitzvot ma'asim tovim, you're going to have a problem there. You're going to have a big, big problem. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu will tell you, well, what did you bring with you? What did you bring with you? I will send you down there to compare Olam HaEmet to Olam HaSheker. To compare the word here with the word there. Now we came here with what? With what? Nothing. What? So HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us an advice. At the beginning, the neshama don't want to come to this world. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu for the neshama. It's very important for you to go down there to know the difference between there and here. And then when you come, you will see you will not come with empty hand. You will come with premises. You will come with mitzvot, ma'asim tovim. And then when you do all this traveling, all this journey for nothing, and you come up there with nothing, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he's going to tell you, well, where is, what did you bring with you? The Gemara said, Ashrei Mishiba Adikan V'Talmudo V'Yado. What a big zichut, what a big merit. A man who passed away and he arrived there with his Talmud, with the Torah, Mitzvot, Ma'atzim Tovim. Why? Because when they send him from the, up there, down here, they send him with nothing. They only send him to study, to do, it's like you do business. I mean, to do business, you need money, you need credit card. So from up there, they give you Torah. That with Torah, you do business. What kind of business? Mitzvot, ma'asim tovim. After when you go up there, 120 years after, you come with mitzvot, Torah, ma'asim tovim. You come like a rich man. You come with a lot of wealth, a spiritual wealth. Then, what happened? Then, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is happy. Ay. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is so happy. So Rabotai, with this happiness, HaKadosh Baruch Hu is happy. The man said to Hashem, Rebbeinu Shel Olam, I would like just to thank you with the Torah that you give me. Without the Torah, Lulei Torah Torah Shah Shuai, Azavati Oni. If Hashem did not give me the Torah, without the Torah, I will be lost there. I'll be finished. Ay. Arami Oved Avi. Sarah is very, very malam. He's very strong. He's very, 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 very intelligent. How much he fooled me. He fooled me millions of times. But Baruch Hashem, through the Torah, I beat him. Thank you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Thank you. Thank you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu. But Ashkifa Me'on Kodshecha, please, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, give to those people who still remain down there, give them koach, give them strength to carry on fighting the Tzara. Rabotai, you should know one thing. In this Olam, don't think it's easy. In this Olam, there is a big, big fight. To remain a Jew, to remain Yehudi, Yeri Shamayim, it's not easy. Behemet, it's not easy. It's very, very, very strong. The Tzara is so strong. The Tzara is so strong. So you cannot imagine, without the Torah, without the Torah, Hasvi Shalom. Do you see this telephone? This is a Tzara. This is a Tzara. You see, we focus on something, we think about something, done, telephone, to disconnect you from Hashem. This is wherever you go, like Mr. Tishayim said, wherever you go, Yitzhak is with you. You go to bed, Yitzhak is with you in bed. You wake up, he wake up with you. You go to eat, he eat with you. Wherever you go, you go to vacation, he go with you. He don't leave you 1 minute. He will not give you a minute. He'll be with you all the time. And this is this beautiful parasha. How much a man should be. Now we are Rosh Hashanah and Kippur. If you want to be Zohi, if Be'ez Hashem, we want to have success and this judgment with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Be'ez Hashem. Don't think it's easy. Don't think it's easy. Yes. The world is so beautiful. It's so nice. But don't forget, it's nice. It's very nice. But you can make it nicer when you take advantage, when you use this word with brachot, you eat with brachot, you wake up in the morning, you wash your hand, you eat, you do Bekat Amazon, you pray to Hashem, you fix hours for Torah. So you feel the time with mitzvot. After 120 years, you go up there, mitzvot ma'asim tovim, all the mitzvot, you give priority to mitzvot. That's why Bikurim is from the word Bechor. You take its mitzvah for you. It's a priority. It's a Bechor. I want to do this. I want to eat. No, before I eat, I want to wash my hand. I want to eat. No, before you eat, there is a bracha. A bracha, you make the bracha as a Bechor. That's what you bring to Hashem with you. When you go up there after 120 years, after 120 years that you've been away from Olam Ha'emet, you come with a lot of business. Because the Torah, we call the Torah Ta'ma Kitov Sahara. The Torah is a business, an esek. Esek. Like you do business, when you study Torah, you do mitzvah, it's a business. It's my business. You fly, you spend money. What did it tell you on the plane? Thank you for your business. Yeah. Mitzvot, it's a business. You do business with Yetzara. Yetzara, he said, don't do it. And I tell him, yes, I do it. Yes, I do. It's a fight. It's a fight, Rabotai. My friend, I would like to tell you this. Atem, Nitzavim, Hayom, Kulchem. The connection with the parasha of Nitzavim, it's how much a man should not change his life. He should not be one day like this, one day like this, one day like this. No. How much we have to study. How much we have to study from this. To take advantage of the beauty of the Torah is the best. This is Rabotai, the Tzara. We make everything to make the world, the Olam Hazeh, the best of the best. But the Torah is the best of the best of the best. Because only that we will take with you. The rest will remain, it will remain here. So, Atem Mitzavim Hayom Kulchem Lifnei Hashem Elokechem. The same, Hashem, Moshe Rabbeinu said to the Bnei Yisrael, you are standing. You are, each moment, Rabbeinu, there is two ways, and forgive me to tell you this. There will be two times that we will be standing in front of Hashem for a judgment. Once, it's every year, and the other one, after 120 years. We're standing in front of Hashem for the big judgment. Once every year, the judgment for all what he did during the year, and once after 120 years. So at least, Rabotai, this is the connection. Don't forget, they send you from up there, down here, but to be always Nitzav, standing in your mind with an Avodat Hashem. Don't change. You know your duty. You know why you came to this world. You know what they're asking from you from up there. Always you have to think. My friend, a man after 120 years, he'll be judged for all what he did. Small things, big things. Rashechem, from big things to the small things. And I would like just to finish with a small story. I was reading last week about Rab Chaim Volozhin, Alav Shalom. One day, one of his students passed away, and he told him, you know, Ephraim, X Luni, he passed away. Ah, so let me know before the Levaya. I want to go to the Levaya with before you bury them. I want to go. So when they called him, Ephraim Volozhin was the David of the Gaon of Vilna. He saw his student sitting on his grave. He told him, "What do you do here? Why look inside the grave?" He said, "Well, I have a big problem because I borrowed some money from my neighbor and I paid him. And then on Rosh Hashanah, when I told him, when I shook hands with him, he told me, 'You know that the money I lend you, you did not pay me all of it. You paid me only a part of it, most of it, but it remained a dollar. Excuse me, pardon. I will give this to my wife to give it to you.' So he gave the dollar to his wife. A dollar is nothing, nothing. He gave the dollar to his wife. Please, you give it to the neighbor. And in the meantime, he said, 'My wife, she forgot the dollar. And then I pass away. And they have a problem. They don't want to let me in. For $1. I was your student. I studied Torah all my life. And they give me a chance because, after all, I did everything correct. For $1. But please, Rabbi, if you can help me, if you can ask for my wife to give him the dollar so they can let me in to Gan Eden." And Ephraim Volozhin, Alav Shalom, he went to his wife and he told her, "Remember, your husband gave you..." "Yes, oh, I forgot. Now, come with me. I want to make sure that you give the dollar back to your neighbor." At night he had a dream, Ephraim Volozhin, that his student, he told him, "Thank you very much. I am now in my place." Can you imagine, my friend, what kind of judgment there is up there? We cannot imagine. Because the Tzara is so strong. The Tzara, he make this world so beautiful, so nice. So he just wants us to enjoy, to forget the reality, the truth. That way, this world, it's Olam HaSheker. Why? Because if we will discover the Torah, the Olam HaEmet, we will realize that we really live in the Olam HaSheker. Because only through the Torah, you can change this Olam to be as well Olam HaEmet. You can enjoy yourself with kashrut. You can eat kasher. You live with kashrut. Whatever you do, your thought will be kasher. Everything. You can, if you want. You Bebet. How old those tzaddikim? They were tzaddikim this world. Just, why they are magic? Why they are malachim? No, they are not malachim. They are human beings. They were here, like you, like me. And what happened to them? Nothing happened to them. It's just through the Torah, they knew how to live. Only through the Torah, they knew how to live. Through Torah and mitzvot. Giving always priority to Hashem. The Baal Shem Tov said, why there is a problem with people that they have no Yirat Shamayim? The Baal Shem Tov said, because when they wake up, they give priority to business. They give priority to themselves. They give priority to a lot of things. They leave Hashem till the end. That's why they lose their Yirat Shamayim. But when you wake up in the morning, you thought it's Modi, thank you Hashem, then you pray, and then you are connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You will have your Yirat Shamayim in your hand all the time. This is Rabotai, you have to be, don't change. The problem is we change. Today, like Kippur. On Kippur, we are nitzavim lifnei Hashem. On Kippur, we are standing in front of HaKadosh. On Yom Kippur, we feel we are in Gan Eden. On Yom Kippur, we feel we are flying. We are out of the ground on Yom Kippur. And after Kippur, we'll take the cigarettes, the coffee, we start talking. How was the fast? Have you been angry? I was starving at 1 o'clock. No, I was starving at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. What it is? We're not talking about people. We don't even talk. Did you pray well? Have you connected to Hashem? Did you feel Hashem? We don't talk about that. We talk about food. We talk about other things. So, it's a, that way there is a halakha. Straight away, after Kippur, start beating the sugar. From Kedusha to Kedusha. From good things to good things. Because inside is very big. Be'emet Rabotai. A lot of people after Kippur, after the Shofar, they ran away already. No Arbit. They forgot to do Arbit. So why you did Kippur? You've been standing in front of Hashem all day for nothing. For nothing. That's why Rabotai, Atem Mitzavim Hayom. You are standing today. What does that mean today? Da Rosh Hashanah, on Rosh Hashanah. But you should know, Rosh Hashanah, it's every day. And I finished. The first day of the year is Rosh Hashanah. And all the days after is one day after Rosh Hashanah. 2 days after Rosh Hashanah. But always, all the days after Rosh Hashanah, the 365 days of the year are connected with the first day. So each day it's Rosh Hashanah. I am 63-year-old. But my 63 years are connected with the first year. Yes or no? Otherwise, I will tell you, I am 62-year-old. There is a connection between the year and the first year. So all the years should be Atem Nitzavim Hayom. Every day we should feel we are standing in front of Hashem. Like in Rosh Hashanah. Don't change. Don't change. This is the connection. Because you have duty. You have work to do. You have something to do in this world. You've been sent from up there to choose, to see, to compare between up there and down there. That, so, you are here, you do a comparison. And the meantime, you forgot. You go up there, wow! You arrive there, ay, 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 what's going on? Oh, la, la, they sent me to compare. Oh, la, la, I forgot. Oh, la, 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 la. Ay, hold me this, Sarah. You have forgot. And the Kashmir will give you the Torah to remind you. To remind you that you've been sent from Olam HaEmet to the Olam HaSheker. To make a comparison between this olam to the other olam, so et Hashem, you can come with business, you can come with a mitzvot, bikurim, asitovim, and then you will say to Hashem, thank you, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, for all what you did for me, and then you will ask Hashem, please Hashem, help the others that they remain there, help them to fight the tzara. But if you want, et Hashem, to have success in your duty in this world, Atem Nitzavim. You have to be stand. You are standing. Make sure, don't change your mind. Once you know the reality, carry on. Atem is the word Atem, Alev, Tav, Mem, the same letters of Emet. Emet is Olam Emet. Olam Emet. That means, Rabotai, Atem, it's in this world, you are in Olam HaEmet. When? When you are in front of Hashem. When you feel Hashem. If you feel Hashem, so you are here. You can be in Manhattan, you can be in the Zengov, you can be in Elat, you can be, I don't know where, you can be in Paris. You are in front of Hashem. You feel Hashem. This week, Rabotai told you yesterday that when I had to pass a bet. A bad area in Paris, very, very, very area full of prostitutes, full of a very, very bad area, and I had no chance. I had no way. I had to pass through there, and it was very, and I didn't have any. There was no other way. I had to pass through there, and I said to myself, "Well, David." And the other people that they were with me, we took two bodyguards. Why we took the bodyguards? Just that because we cannot look up So we have, they have to show us like a blind people. They have to show us the way to go. Just we follow their foot, their feet, because it was not possible to see. And that, as I said yesterday, for 1 hour, our eyes were sick on the floor, and then we heard a big Akar, he did a
breaks.
You heard the noise. And I told people, those who were with me, don't turn. Just carry on. And then I said to the bodyguard, to them, what happened behind? He said, nothing, just a car. He arrived to the traffic light, so that he would not burn the traffic light, he had to stop to break down. And he said, but Rabbi, you did well that you did not turn. I said, why? Because those people were crossing the street were very, very bad. You see this, Sarah, he wants you to look. It's Sarah, he wants you to look. And it's a fight. There was a man who came to see me yesterday, a few days ago. He was crying. He said, Rabbi David, please help me. Help me, I will do a big donation. Just help me. Give me an idea. I said, what? He said, well, I saw something very bad, and every time I pray, this picture comes to my mind. I told him, you have to cry. You have to pray, Hashem. I cannot help you. I'm worried to tell you, give me a donation, and I will not help you. I cannot help you. You can only help yourself. You have to pray to Hashem to forgive you and be careful for the future. This is Rabotei Kippur. Kippur is not just, please Hashem forgive me, and after I carry on. No. You have to work hard, not to change. Stand. Now you are standing in front of Hashem on Yom Kippur. So carry on. After Kippur. Rabotei, Be'ezat Hashem, pray for you, that Hashem give you Baracha ve'atzlacha ve'et Hashem. And don't forget, life is short. You can live 120 years, it's short. Be'emet. Oh, look, who is my father? Who is my grandfather? This is life. But Baruch Hashem, we are here only for a duty. We are here for something. Don't miss the goal. We are here for something. We are not here just to, yes, we can eat, we can enjoy ourselves, we can laugh, we can dance, we can enjoy ourselves. But just be careful. You can do anything you want, but with kashrut. With kashrut. Not with, with kashrut. Do it in the right way. But otherwise, God forbid you, if you want to live as you want, you will miss your goal. And I would like just to finish. Please give me 1 minute and I finish. There was a man, yesterday. I was somewhere yesterday. And Bemet, I'm telling you, Bemet, this man, he has so much problems. And you know what kind of, and Bemet, his children on drugs. It's millions of problems. And you know what he came? What he told me, Rabbi David, among all the problems that I have the big problem I have, that my children, they don't put tefillin, they bring not kosher the home. And I told him, tell me, do you put tefillin? You put. He said, one day yes, one day no. So I said, well, you say, one day yes, one day no. Your son, you see that you don't give cover to the tefillin, so you don't put them. How? You accuse us, you complain about your son, that he doesn't eat kosher. You complain about your son that he don't put tefillin, but you put tefillin. And he told him, yes, you put tefillin, That means we want for our children what we don't do for ourselves. That's not a good education. You want that your children eat kosher, put tefillin. So put tefillin first. When you don't put tefillin to protect you, so then there is no kosher, there is nothing. This is a terrible. We want for our children to do what we do, what we don't do. It doesn't make sense. That's what the Torah said, atem mitzavim, you are standing. I mean, you have to be steady. Don't move, don't do what they did, what they did. If you have to carry on, it's like Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah is Rosh Hashanah. It's for all year Rosh Hashanah, not Rosh Hashanah for one day. Kippur is Kippur for all the year, not Kippur for one day. Be'ez Hashem, all of us. Be'ez Hashem, we have a good Kippur.
Amen.
We will
Amen.
Not change. Ye'er Ratzon, Shinizkei, Li'at Mishal Tzidkenu, Li'mera Bi'aminu, Amen Ke'er Ratzon, Rav Jacker, Toda Rabba, for all the work you do here. בזכות רבחים תדעו תגיד בעדך
אמן
אבי שאתה שכוי לך ברכה והצלחה עוד יותר מתק פודו מקום תנק מייקל אבי שאתה שכוי לך ברכה והצלחה
אמן
תנק יו אבי
והילול אלה סיטו על הרבי דוד ביטו אמן